One and all. At the outset, we are delighted to welcome all of you to this function and thank you for consenting to our request. May I request you to please stand as we are joined by the Honorable Governor of Kerala, Justice P. Sathasivam, on behalf of the Kerala Economic Association and Institute for Sustainable Development and Governance. I would like to extend
जनगण मन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल वंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मागे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे
May I invite Dr. Manju S. Nair, Head Department of Economics, to give the welcome speech.
Good morning, everybody. Honorable Governor, Sri Justice P. Sathasivam, Srimati Saraswati Sathasivam, Professor M. A. Oommen, Dr. Amit Shravan Ray, Dr. Ash Narayan Roy, Sri T. P. Senkumar IPS, Dr. A. N. Mathai, Sri John Samuel, Sri Gauri Dasan Nair, other dignitaries, and dear friends. As you are aware, we are here for the release of the book Development, Decentralization and Democracy and for honoring Professor M. A. Oommen for his contributions and for participating in the National Seminar on Development, Decentralization and Democracy. For releasing the book and for honoring Professor M.A. Oommen, we have Honorable Governor and former Chief Justice of India, Sri Justice P. Sathasivam, who has to his credit several path-breaking judgments besides his efforts towards creating awareness of people's rights and privileges. On behalf of the Kerala Economic Association and on behalf of Institute of Sustainable Development and Governance and all who have assembled here, I extend a very warm welcome to Sri Justice P. Sathasivam. We are blessed with the presence of Srimati Saraswati Sathasivam. Warm welcome to you, Madam, to this function. Honoring and expressing our love and regards to the renowned social scientist, Professor M.A. Oommen, is the purpose of this program. Oommen sir, as we students affectionately call him, has always been our professor whom we have adored and held high as a person committed to teaching, research and policy making. Professor Oommen started his career at the Department of Economics, University of Kerala, and could create a strong academic foundation for our department. Inspired by him, his successors at the Department of Economics have always tried to uphold his values and traditions. With great love and respect, we welcome our dear Professor Dr. M.A. Oommen. Director, Center for Development Studies, Dr. Amit Shivendre, will deliver the presidential address. Editor of the book, Development, Decentralization and Democracy, who is Director, Institute of Social Sciences, New Delhi, Dr. Ash Naren Roy, will introduce the book. Warm welcome to Dr. Amit Shivendre and Dr. Ash Naren Roy. For offering felicitations, we have dignitaries who have made indelible contributions in their respective fields. Sri T.P. Senkumar, IPS, DGP and State Police Chief Kerala, who is also the student of Professor M.A. Oommen. Dr. A.M. Mathai, Emeritus Professor, McGill University, Canada. Sri John Samuel, International Consulting Advisor, UNDP, Bangkok and President, ISDGA. Professor Maman Varki, former Principal, Bishopmur College, Mavelikera. And Sri Gauri Dasan Nair, Bureau Chief, The Hindu, are here. Warm welcome to all of you. Family members, friends, colleagues, well-wishers and students of Professor M.A. Oommen are here to be a part of this honoring ceremony. Greetings and welcome to all of you on behalf of the Kerala Economic Association and Institute of Sustainable Development and Governance. Thank you.
Honorable Governor of Kerala, Sri P. Sathasivam, my guru in a certain Ekalavya sense, Dr. Oommen, other dignitaries on the dais and off the dais, a very warm good morning to all of you. Dr. Oommen has been a guru to me and many like me in the media, along with a lot of others outside the media and in the field of academics. And personally, I've gained a lot from him, and this is my Guru Puja, coming here and felicitating him. I thank the Kerala Economic Association and ISDG for this opportunity. Dr. Oommen has been one of those persons with an abiding interest in decentralization and democracy, particularly the aspect of decentralization when it comes to the decentralization and devolving of fiscal resources, the utilization by the local government institutions, and also looking at the general public finance issues of Kerala and elsewhere. He's an economist and a social scientist rolled into one, looking at diverse aspects of life in his teaching, in his academic pursuits and his interactions with, you know, even very knowledgeable persons and lay persons like me. And we have gained a lot of insight about the realm of public finance, which I would think is an orphan today in today's India. Not many people seem to be really worried about issues of public finance these days. And with the result that a lot of analytical, rigorous analytical work on issues affecting public finance and the way in which finances are managed by the state at different levels are getting ignored. And this is one juncture where a person, the presence of a person like, the critical presence of a person like Professor Oommen becomes very crucial to our understanding of the economic context in which we live and the manner in which the finances of this place, be it by the union government or the state or by the local governments, are managed. So I think we owe a lot to this man for having taught us a lot of lessons along with a lot of others, and who still guides generations and generations of students and academic scholars as also laypersons through the very difficult terrains of economic analysis and also financial analysis, and also looking at the social dimension of each rupee that is spent by the state at different levels. So I take this opportunity to felicitate with all the respect that is at my command, Professor Oommen, and I wish him a long life, very active life. Thank you very much.
I take this opportunity to invite Professor Marman Varki, former Principal Bishop Moore College, for the felicitation.
Honorable Governor, esteemed Oommen sir, distinguished guests, and my dear friends, with profound joy, may I, on behalf of the ecumenical collective of academics and activists Vichara, and all of us gathered here, offer to our respected Oommen sir our affectionate, hearty felicitations. He has been our parent figure in our incisively analytical and impressively innovative academic pursuits.
Governor, dignitaries on the dais and off the dais, I would like to say only a few words. I knew Dr. Oommen starting from 1985. We worked very closely in building up the Center for Mathematical and Statistical Sciences. Now it is built up into an international center of excellence. And major contribution comes from the council members, and he was the chairman of the executive committee for all these years. Now, what I found in him was the scientific attitude towards work. Whatever he is doing, he would like to have it precise and proper scientific output from the work. So I had helped him in some statistical matters, but I found this very rare characteristics in a person coming from the art sides or social sciences side. So he should have been a good scientist in science field. You would have done extremely well because he has the proper attitude towards work and also towards scientific work, and how to write a paper and how to bring it to an international level of excellence. That I had found him. I found only rarely in many people here, and he is one of them, and I wish him a long, long life and very successful output in training people and also in making policy matters and things like that. Thank you very much.
Let me invite a personality well known for his integrity and excellent track record, Sri T.P. Senkumar, IPS, Director General of Police and State Police Chief Kerala, for the felicitation.
President of the function, Dr. Amit Shwandrai, Honorable Governor of Kerala, Justice P. Sathasivam sir, Oommen sir, eminent persons on the dais and off the dais. I am immensely happy and honored to say a few words of felicitation, or rather a gurudakshina, to my revered teacher. He was my teacher for my postgraduate course in economics at the Calicut University, Dr. John Mathai Center, which was a unique experiment in economic teaching in the state under Calicut University. Although under different circumstances, this course was discontinued. Eminent compeers of mine such as Dr. Paul Anthony, professor at Cambridge University, Dr. Ravi Raman, formerly of the Manchester University, who is happened to be here today, Mathai Nurnal with the UN Human Rights Commission, and several others bear ample testimony to the success of this productive experiment. Kerala's crab culture, they did not try to raise the others to that level, but actually brought them down to their level and dismantled the system. I got the Indian Economic Service first, certainly helped by my schooling at the John Mathai Center under Oommen sir. Even after I entered the police service, I continued my association with Professor Oommen sir, who is my guide in my PhD dissertation as well, along with helped by A.M. Mathai sir also. I always used to wonder whether the decision makers at sometimes refer to such great work before they take decisions on socio-economic matters. Because I have found that what I learned in Dr. John Mathai Center, especially about the definition of economics by Robbins, Daniel Robbins, that has helped me a lot, because I worked not only in police but outside 12 years in public sector, where I always found that his teaching on human behavior as a relationship between limited resources and unlimited ones, which have alternative uses, always helping me even now. I also take it this great privilege, this as a great privilege for getting an opportunity to attend this function. I also pray that Oommen sir and madam and family be endowed with the continued health. In fact, I have to say, Oommen sir's granddaughter has joined my tribe in Karnataka, so she is also here. I also pray that Oommen sir and madam and family members be endowed with continued health to come out with many more path-breaking insights into the field of socio-economic aspects. Because 60 years of work, at 60, we All India Service Officers retired. Oommen sir has already done 60 years of service in the field of economics and social sciences. This is actually unimaginably long period. I hope much more is to come. I only pray that his health continue to help him to give much more to us. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. We are fortunate to have with us Dr. Ashnurin Roy, the first author of the book to be released this morning. Let me invite Dr. Ashnurin Roy to introduce the book.
Honorable Governor, Sri Justice Sathasivam, dignitaries on the dais, distinguished invitees. I feel greatly humbled but also overwrought in this august presence of men and women of excellence. Let me say at the outset that it is impossible to talk about the book in 5 minutes, and hence I will only be making a few points. German writer Goethe once said, when ideas fall, words come in handy. As they say, after all, words mean the words. To my mind, the three key words, development, decentralization, and democracy, that the title of the volume contains, define words in the making. These three are also important catchwords in the contemporary development discourse. Initially, development, decentralization, and democracy constitute the core of the work that Professor Oommen has done over the last 60 years. Not only has he made seminal contribution in these three critical areas, he has also influenced the generation of scholars in India and abroad. The book is indeed immensely challenging, particularly for all those engaged in development and those grappling with the issues that matter for equity and social justice. The main thrust of this volume is that development is much more than a socio-economic endeavor. It also conveys the idea that tomorrow things will be different, and not that more will necessarily be better. In the globalizing, hyper-connected postmodern world, these three catchwords are taking a new meaning altogether. Democracy itself is not just an idea, but also an ideal. It's not just social movement, but also a political system. It is in between the citizens and society, an arbiter, but also the connecting link between the two. In the future, some scholars maintain democracy, decentralization, and development will probably be something different. Today, development itself has become a buzzword. And as you know, buzzwords often tend to become fuzzwords. Growth is not just cherry on the cake or a glass of champagne. It is equity and equitable resource allocation. This is exactly the thrust of this volume. The volume is an endearing testament to the scholarship of Professor Oommen, who has spent a lifetime researching on the theme. The breadth of perspectives and scholarship is one of the primary strengths of this volume. Another strength is that the chapters are not isolated islands or standalone pillars. There is a running thread that binds all chapters. American economist Paul Samuelson once said, the only coin of worth among economists is the recognition among the peers. This is exactly true of Professor Oommen. Many economists suffer from what Paul Romer calls mathiness, using math to obfuscate rather than to clarify. But Professor Oommen is among those who believes not in ignoring the real world behavior. But Professor Oommen is among those who believes not in ignoring the real world behavior in favor of a model. Let me, on behalf of the Institute of Social Sciences, thank each one of the contributors for their help and patience. I would also like to acknowledge all those colleagues and friends of Professor Oommen who would have liked to contribute a chapter but couldn't, because either we were unable to contact them or they were unaware of the initiative. Last but not the least, I'm grateful to the Kerala Economic Association and the Institute for Sustainable Development and Governance for organizing this program. By doing this volume in honor of Professor Oommen, the Institute has honored itself. Thank you very much.
We thank you, sir, and its eminent contributors and all others who directed their energies towards its publication. The mediocre teacher tells, the good teacher explains, the superior teacher demonstrates, the great teacher inspires. Let us pay tribute to our source of inspiration, Professor M.A. Oommen, a man of distinct vision, a fountainhead of illuminating ideas, a well-known scholar. We know for certain that this tribute conveys only a tip of the iceberg of Professor Oommen's multifaceted profile. Let's have a look at the audiovisual, an academic journey down the memory lane.
Professor M.A. Oommen, called Mao by his closest friends, is a multifaceted personality with a high caliber of academic excellence and social commitment. With his visionary and profound human approach, he extended the frontiers of economics. A Syrian Christian with a cosmopolitan worldview was born in a remote village, Venmani, in Pathanamthitta district of Kerala. Oommen was the first to get a postgraduate degree in his village, now a home to a large number of educated expatriates. A brilliant student, Oommen is the first first-class rank holder in MA Economics in 1954, the first PhD in Economics, the first faculty member to open up a Department of Economics in Kerala University. He was the first professor of Economics in Calicut University. The list is manifold. It's difficult to capture the salience of a prolific and productive life spread over six decades, with over 30 books in English and Malayalam and 300 papers in the time span of a few minutes. Professor Oommen was a born teacher, a public intellectual, a policy practitioner, above all a humanist of principles and high morale. Oommen as a teacher was loved and respected by students. He was ideal, evincing the real interest in seeing that his students understood the subject. Some random snippets, certainly not exhaustive, are enlisted herein. He was the first to launch a semester system for economics with a unique curriculum and examination system when he was the professor of economics in Calicut University. Dr. Paul Anthony Cartman, Professor, Cambridge University, Mathai Noorunal IPS, who is in the UN Human Rights Commission, Dr. Ravi Raman, a scholar in the world of social sciences, Sri Senkumar IPS, Director General of Police in Kerala, are the products of this outstanding experiment. KT Chako IAS, retired director and vice chancellor of Indian Institute of Foreign Trade, New Delhi, wrote in Times of India, "MA Oommen, my teacher of MA Economics in the University of Kerala, is an individual whom I consider a constant source of inspiration." NS Madhavan, IAS, retired Chief Secretary, Government of Bihar, remarked, "I feel a lifelong debt to Dr. Oommen for making me aware at a young age what can be broadly termed as human condition." Dr. P.J. Alexander, IPS, former DGP of Kerala, commented that Professor Oommen was sure of his facts to impress with clarity. Written evidences like this gather. Oommen, as a public intellectual, he is clearly committed to the cause of economic and social progress in his home state. John Greaves, the great collaborator of Amartya Sen, wrote in the foreword to Oommen's Essays on Kerala Economy, "Professor Oommen's scholarly analysis is exemplary." On Oommen's thesis, submitted for his PhD in 1967 on small industries in Kerala, Varanasi, Professor London School of Economics wrote, "Each aspect of the other subject is analyzed in a scholarly manner, descriptively done." Professor Sanders, Drake University, USA, wrote on Oommen's thesis, "A splendidly done piece of work which forms such as an important part of economics." Professor K.N. Raj wrote in his foreword to Oommen's work, Land Reforms and Socio-Economic Changes in Kerala in 1971, speaks of the pertinent questions he raises, very relevant and important. Economics of Cinema, a pioneer work written with Dr. K.V. Joseph, published by Oxford and IBH, is probably the first book on the subject in India. Oommen wrote on globalization both in Malayalam and English. Those who appreciated and encourage his writings on globalization include Malcolm Adisesheya, City Kurian, Ashok Mitra, Father Huthart, and Tissa Balasuria. The book Economic Justice, Globalization and Quest for Alternatives, with a foreword by I.K. Gujral, the former Prime Minister, carries 10 articles on globalization. The edited volume in Malayalam has run into several editions. The first book on Botswana economy, published by McGraw-Hill, was edited by Professor Oommen. He had incurred the wrath of the Botswana government for his plain talk on the budget, Richmond's budget, and his refusal to withdraw led to his dismissal. The scholars and policy makers have acknowledged Oommen as the leading exponent of the theory and practice of democratic decentralization in India since the 73rd and 74th constitutional amendments. Professor Oommen's book, Issues in Teaching of Economics in Indian Universities, published in 1987, attracted considerable professional attention, especially from the scholars and teachers of eminence like Amiya Bakshi, Vinod Vyasalu, Ambi Rajan, Sukhumoy Chakrabarti, Krishna Bharadwaj, to mention the most prominent. His passion for teaching continued till this day, as well exemplified in the speech on his 80th birthday, The Meaning of Development, Reflections of an Octogenarian Teacher of Economics, later published in Social Change. Professor Oommen guided a large number of national and international projects, organized conferences on high standards, delivered lectures of an amazing capacity, chaired commissions discharging the entrusted assignment successfully, submitted reports properly analyzed and presented in a scholarly manner, speak on the contributions of a professor, a wonderful example to strive, to seek, to find and to follow. As a policy practitioner, one can find easily the humanitarian arm stretching towards the life of a common man. Professor Oommen, a humanist. A short and lean man, Professor Oommen is a man of high caliber, sincerely devoted and committed for the poor and the marginalized. The chapter on inclusion of the excluded in the State Finance Commission report declares his deep concern for the poor and the excluded. As a true humanist, Professor Oommen could touch the next generation, cutting across caste, class and creed. We would like to conclude with the words of Professor Oommen. There's a great distinction between economics and ethics. Today, the organizing principles of global economy and governing institutions is the creation of wealth per se and not preservation and glorification of life. The economy and the economic activity arise from the basic need to preserve life, which leads to fundamental values such as freedom, justice and participation. It's high time that economics reevaluate their conceptual foundations. With regards to the bone teacher living through the lives of his students, and let Professor Oommen's fingerprints continue to manifest in the spheres of visionary and profound human approach. Thank you.
Honorable Governor of Kerala, Justice Sathasivam, my esteemed colleague, Honorary Fellow of CDS, Professor M.A. Oommen, Dr. Ashnarayan Roy, eminent social scientist and editor of this volume, distinguished members of the Kerala Economic Association, members on the dais, ladies and gentlemen. It is my great privilege and honor to preside over this important ceremony where our Honorable Governor has most kindly agreed to release this pioneering volume on development, decentralization and democracy. On behalf of the Kerala Economic Association and all of us present here, I extend a warm welcome to our Honorable Governor, sir. The book being released today is dedicated to Professor M.A. Oommen, one of the leading economists of the day. We have just had a glimpse of his life, contribution, and personality. I would like to highlight one dimension of his contribution, and that is his active involvement in policy making and decisions on decentralization and development, not only as a member of several high-powered committees of the government, but also as an advisor, a task force member, and an author of several government commission papers. This is something that we are losing out in the academic world. We tend to remain confined to the ivory towers of our academic abstractions, while the policymakers, I may say if so, often fail to appreciate the importance of research-based ideas and inputs for informed policymaking. As a result, unlike in many advanced countries, Indian academia and Indian policymakers tend to live in splendid isolation from each other. However, I hasten to add that in the past, we have seen great academics like P.C. Mahalanobis, Sukumai Chakrabarti, Ken Raj, and many others in their avatars as an active policymaker, shaping the coordinates of the country's development trajectory. Such great academics could contribute so effectively because they could come out of their theoretical abstractions and apply their research ideas to the real world of policy formulation. Incidentally, the founder of the institution that I happen to be heading right now, Center for Development Studies, Trivandrum, was founded by the noted economist K.N. Raj, who was not only a distinguished professor and director of the Delhi School of Economics, Vice Chancellor of Delhi University, but he also played an important role in India's development policy formulation, as we all know, in the post-independent era, drafting the first five-year plan, working out a strategy to raise India's savings rate, computing India's balance of payments for the first time for the Reserve Bank of India, and so on. On his return to Kerala after retirement, K.N. Raj founded CDS, perhaps with a vision to foster and create this space for academia-policy interface. I'm proud to note that we at CDS are now well established as a leading research institution in the country, producing cutting-edge, world-class research on development issues. And we are eminently poised for such policy interface. For an effective academia policy interface, both sides must make an effort to understand and appreciate each other. The academics must be able to convert their ideas into simple, implementable policy language, while the policymakers and the civil servants must be open to new and innovative challenges posed by the academics. I hope all of us in the academic profession may take a pledge today to follow the example of Professor M.A. Oommen, who is right here with us, in trying to reach out to policymakers with innovative and informed policy inputs that could strengthen the path of our progress and development. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We have cherished for long to share a stage with this illustrious personality, a distinguished jurist, a legal luminary, above all, the former Chief Justice of India. Sri Justice P. Sathasivam's judicial philosophy is humane and biased in favor of the downtrodden and has been meticulous in interpreting the law, irrespective of who the litigants are. An impartial and objective judicial functionary, Sri Justice P. Sathasivam has to his credit a plethora of decisions like the Reliance Gas judgment, the Mumbai blast case, the sensational case of triple murder of Australian Christian missionary Graham Stott Staines, to name a few. May I invite this great personality to release the book and to honor Professor M.A. Oommen. We kindly request Sri Justice P. Sathasivam to kindly hand over a copy of book to Sri T.P. Sen Kumar, IPS. Thank you, sir. May I humbly request Sri Justice P. Sathasivam to add on Professor M.A. Oommen with a punnada. We kindly request Sri Justice P. Sathasivam to present a memento on behalf of the Kerala Economic Association to Professor M.A. Oommen. We request Professor Oommen to kindly accept the memento as a token of our love and gratitude.
I never thought that they are going to be.
Thank you, sir. Let me invite Dr. Manju S. Nair to present a memento to Professor M. A. Oommen on behalf of the Department of Economics, University of Kerala. I also invite Sri Shaijun D., faculty member, to present a memento to Professor M. A. Oommen on behalf of Department of Economics, Dr. John Mathai Center, University of Calicut. Thank you. May I humbly request Sri Justice P. Sathasivam to address the gathering.
Dr. Amit Shravan Rai, Sri T.P. Shenkumar, Dr. A.N. Mathai, Dr. John Samuel, Professor Mamman Warki, Sri Gauridasan Nair, Dr. Ash Narayan Roy, Dr. Manju S. Nair, Dr. Shija, my friends in media, ladies and gentlemen, good morning to all. I am very much pleased to be here at this August function that has been convened by the Kerala Economic Association to honor Professor M. A. Oommen, eminent economist who has several accomplishments to his credit. I am also entrusted with another pleasant duty which I did, that is to release the volume titled Development, Decentralization and Democracy. At the very outset, I would offer my hearty greetings to Professor Oommen, who is also the founder president and patron of the Kerala Economic Association. I would express my deep sense of gratitude to the association for having invited me, having given me this opportunity to felicitate Professor Oommen along with his disciples and admirers. I am glad that the Kerala Economic Association is a dream come true for Professor, affiliated to the 98-year-old Economic Association. The Kerala Association is a professional body with more than 500 members who include academicians, researchers, students and economic professionals from the state as well as outside. It merits mention that the Kerala Economic Association brings out a biannual newsletter containing its program and discussions held at different institutions at various parts of the state. I am particularly happy that the felicitation volume, namely Development, Decentralization and Democracy, has been edited by Sri Ash Narayan Roy and Sri George Matthew and published by Orient Blacksman. The book, I am told, bears ample testimony to the contributions of Professor Oommen as teacher, researcher and public intellectual, Bharat Ratna recipient and Nobel laureate in economics, Dr. Amartya Sen, his illustrious colleague Jean Dries, the renowned Latin American scholar Henry Waldmeyer, G.K. Litton, a known authority on India's development, and a former professor at the University of Amsterdam, and several others have contributed papers to this volume. Indeed, this reflects the esteem in which he is held among the community of scholars in India and abroad. Professor Oommen was the foremost first rank holder in MA Economics of Kerala University, the first faculty member to start the University Department of Economics, and first ranker in Diploma in Economic Development of the Institute for the Study of Economic Development, NEPELS. He was also the first PhD holder in economics from the Kerala University, the first professor of Calicut University, and Dr. John Mathai Center. He also launched a few semester system way back in 1977, I would also like to quote from a letter by Sri K.T. Chako, IAS retired, Director and Vice Chancellor of Indian Institute of Foreign Drug, that was published in Times of India, reflecting the feelings of most of his students. I quote, M.A. Oommen, my teacher of postgraduate economics at University of Kerala, is an individual whom I consider a constant source of inspiration. A professional to the core with total commitment to his vocation, Oommen undertook extensive research on the most recent developments in his areas of interest. His research was always contemporary in nature. As a teacher, he had an amazing capacity to spend time with his students, unquote. I may also be permitted to quote from the foreword to Professor Oommen's first book, Land Reforms and Socio-Economic Change in Kerala, written by late Professor K.N. Raj himself, an acclaimed authority in economics. I quote, indeed, the value of the work lies to a large extent in the number of pertinent questions it raises. It is a merit of his approach that changes in land relations are viewed not only in terms of their economic implications, but with reference to their impact on the social structure. While this does not make his task easier, the issues raised are certainly very relevant and important, unquote. Before proceeding further, I want to mention two instances. Now, I had an occasion to go through this, one of his books, and I can proudly say that he is a friend of a common man. Because I come from a judiciary, 25 years as a lawyer, 20 years as a judge in three places, a decade at Chennai and a few months in Chandigarh and 7 years at Delhi. Persons holding high post, either economics, politics or judiciary or whatever, first they must learn the feelings of common man of their own country and own place. For this I am going to give two examples which of course I mentioned in many meetings. Whenever I get an opportunity to interact with college students, I will give two illustrations. See, when I was in Supreme Court, it is a practice of the Supreme Court. It is a very disciplined force. I am proudly saying it is a discipline because on many aspects, it is a customary that all judges of the Supreme Court, including the Chief Justice of India, has to assemble at 10:15 in the lounge in order to exchange what is happening in their states every day. So one day while taking tea, coffee or nariyal pani, that is coconut water, I want to convey certain things to my colleagues. At that time, this I mentioned many places, at that time the price of onion was so high because many economists are here. This I mentioned to the conference organized by Agriculture Minister at Cochin. At that time, the onion price has gone up to the level of 75 to 80 per kg. If it is 80 rupees per kg, how is possible for our Indian woman to go and purchase onion? So everybody, all political leaders, members of parliament started hoo and cry. And ultimately the advisors advised our Prime Minister to import onion from foreign countries, including our neighbor Pakistan. And within a month, the price has gone down, it subsidized, reached a normal position. This is one side. I conveyed this. Then my colleague said, yes, Chief, we know all these things. Then I asked another, you may not have the other information. Everybody was anxious to know what is the other one. Same onion at certain period has gone to 3 rupees or 5 rupees per kg. Whether anyone in the government or the elected representative go to the street to agitate, whether raise slogans, nobody bothered the farmer's condition. Because I come from a farmer, every time when I get an opportunity, holiday, I rush to my village. That's why I know nobody knows if it is a 5 rupees or 3 rupees per kg, the farmer has to simply plow it. He cannot harvest and sell it, most uneconomical. Why I am mentioning this? Our professor Oommen, he is a common man's friend. I have gone through some of his writings. So the economic advisors of our country must know the feelings of common man as well as the consumer. In other words, I conveyed the government officials, when you prepare a plan, you have to consider the interest of consumer, because they are very well aware of their loss, go to the street for anything and everything, or in front of secretariat. You must also consider the other group, hidden group, farmer. He must also get a reasonable price. So for this, I thought it is occasion to mention the credit goes to our professor. And another incident knowledge about the local condition, just while sitting here I recollected. During my 7 years tenure at Supreme Court, one day the then Chief Justice of India, Justice Kapadia, allotted one sensational case to me. During lunchtime, he invited me, Brother, I am entrusting this matter to your bench, you have to hear and decide. And I said, yes, Chief, because it is a prerogative of the Chief Justice. That is a sensational murder case that took place at Delhi. The person involved is a son of a big leader of the ruling front. A bartenderer was murdered, killed in a bar hotel after the lean hours around 11 o'clock or 12 o'clock, 12 midnight. Unfortunately, the trial court acquitted. The Delhi High Court reversed the decision and awarded life sentence. That was challenged before the Supreme Court. The Chief Justice thought, being a sensational case, he allotted this case to one south and north. I don't know the reason, it so happened. The other companion judges, that makes no difference. We are all Indians. Why I am mentioning that, when we started hearing this, a very eminent jurist initiated his arguments that his claim that accused has nothing to do with the case. For that, he took us to Australia. Australia means not, he cited many instances that is taking place in Australia and Europe countries by citing several case laws, several instances. In that way, he took 2 full days time. We judges simply noted all his arguments. Third day, while coming from our chamber to the court hall, I reminded my colleague while walking on the corridor, Brother, enough is enough. Last 2 days we learned a lot about Australia, New Zealand and foreign European countries. We have to put full stop to the senior counsel today. Then at 10:30, when we entered the court hall, as usual, the senior advocate, Mr. Ramjet Malani, in his usual style, again, he wanted us to other foreign countries. Then I thought, Mr. So-and-so, we learned several things from you. We are not underestimating, because every day we are learning. But we are concerned about the murder of a young girl in a bar after midnight, after closing of the hours. If you have any evidence, direct evidence, that your client has nothing to do with it, please find out. Why you are we won't say that you wasted our 2 days' time, because every day we are learning. But you cannot compare what is prevailing in Australia to India. There, if one murder takes place in a year, the newspaper carried a headline. Here, every minute one murder is taking place. Please tell me, can we apply that Australian law to India? Sorry, except thanking you for giving some literature, we have to ignore your 2 days argument. We wasted our court's time. Then he pointed out the certain evidence. Why I am mentioning, ultimately we confirmed the life sentence. Why we are mentioning, person holding in any office must know the position prevailing at the lawyer level. And maybe for out of interest, we can read many things, what is happening in other countries. Because our professor has concentrated the feelings of common man, I thought I can mention these two instances. And coming to our present day's function, I am indeed gratified to be part of this auspicious function that honors an outstanding scholar and an acclaimed economist who has abiding faith in the future of his home state. He reiterates that Kerala has succeeded in human development attainments comparable to some of the advanced countries of the world. Before concluding, I will also ardently hope and wish, along with Professor Oommen, that the members of Kerala Economic Association take a sacred promise to lead Kerala to a bright and prosperous future. Jai Hind.
Your gracious presence has enhanced the majesty of today's ceremony. Thank you so much, sir. A long-awaited moment. Let's hear words from a person of eminence on his achievement and satisfaction as a teacher, as an academician, as a scholar, as a true educationist. May I invite Professor M.A. Oommen.
Hon'ble Governor Sri P. Sathasivam, Mrs. Saraswati Sathasivam, my colleagues on the dais, and distinguished friends. This is a momentous moment in my academic sojourn. I am particularly happy and feel honored because a person of the eminence of Justice P. Sathasivam have agreed to come and grace this occasion and address this gathering. Indeed, I am also happy that Sri T.P. Sen Kumar, who is the chief of police, is my student, and also the chief secretary of the state, Gigi Thompson, is also my student, a reality which no God can remove. I am familiar a little bit with the Aristotelian concept of functioning, which is elaborated by Amartya Sen and Martha Nussbaum. Functioning refers to the being and doing of a person. The achieved functionings depends on the capabilities and the freedom that capabilities enhance. When I contemplate the common lot of mortality, I must acknowledge that I have drawn a high prize in the lottery of life. Through hard work and persistent devotion to duty, whatever is assigned to me. In this functioning, if I have the freedom to lead the life that I have reason to value, then that is an attainment. Not any big pose in the state or outside, but pursuing knowledge and truth in a humble way. I have most importantly to speak to the younger counterparts of or compiers, I mean the younger economists present here. While I was a student, I joined as a college lecturer, my salary was 100 rupees, whereas the salary of my counterparts today are 100,000 and more. Not that I feel envious of it. My PhD guide had no PhD because there were no PhDs around. That means also that you have only the Remington typewriter to help you in preparing your thesis or long hands. So your revision is conditioned by your hand, unlike the explosive possibilities of internet open to my colleagues today. These possibilities also, I believe, put on the shoulders of these younger teachers the responsibility of doing research and to take the teaching profession as seriously as one can. If somebody asks me, what is the major problem of Kerala? It certainly is not corruption, which of course is, and the environmental hazards, but the decline in the quality of higher education in the state. Education can be confirmation to the existing reality. It can also be the practice of freedom. That means effort put in to discover how to participate in the transformation of your society, which of course is, and the environmental hazards, but the decline in the quality of higher education in the state. Education can be confirmation to the existing reality. It can also be the practice of freedom. That means effort put in to discover how to participate in the transformation of your society. My appeal as teachers, as the esteemed governor has also pointed out in the talk, is for you to put in your effort to transform and creatively and critically associate with this transformation process of the state. I now would like to thank everyone who have endeavored. I was pleasantly surprised to see all these mementos brought to my notice without being giving me any hint of it. I am really moved by the sincerity of purpose of these people. I am in a personal tone because a man over 80 must mention that I have really thrown a high price in the lottery of life, not taking a big position here, but lead the life that you have reason to cherish and value. In this respect, I am considerably helped by my wife and my family members. And my wife, and we have three wonderful children. They're marvelous to me. I'm particularly happy that my granddaughter flew from Mysore yesterday just to see this function and go back. I thank her for that. I thank my family members who are here. I also thank God Almighty who has created the mighty ocean and even the Leviathan has also provided space for the little fish to frolic in it. And God has given me the grit and grace to face the excruciating ordeals through which I pass every day in my life. I am happy about it. I must also thank several others, in particular Shanta Karthikeyan, who was with me during the last 6 years and provided me support and sustenance. My driver is also an extremely good human being who literally hand holds me. Last but not least, I wish to thank my parents who taught me the value of truth, which is not only an intrinsic value to be pontificated, but an abiding virtue to practice in your life, Sojai. I thank them and remember them. And thank you all once again. And in particular, the esteemed Justice and his distinguished wife, who also chose to be here with us and grace this occasion. And thank you all. Once again, thank you.
We would like to thank Professor M.A. Oommen for bringing us together to accomplish the celebrated event. On behalf of all, I wish Professor M.A. Oommen to continue good health, happiness and even greater glory ahead. May I invite Professor K.N. Harilal, Chairman, Organizing Committee of the Program and Professor, Center for Development Studies, to present a memento to the Honorable Governor, Justice P. Sathasivam. Thank you and appreciation. Thank you, sir. To propose the vote of thanks, let me invite Dr. Shija S.R., Secretary, KEA Trust.
Honorable Governor, Sri Justice P. Sathasivam, and dignitaries on and off the dais, I deem it a great honor to propose vote of thanks on this occasion. At the outset, I place on record our profound gratitude to the Honorable Governor, Sri Justice P. Sathasivam, for his gracious presence and honoring our beloved teacher, Professor M.A. Oommen. Your presence today is a source of encouragement to all of us and has emphatically added grandeur to today's function. On behalf of all, I thank you, sir. We are grateful to Srimati Saraswati Sathasivam for gracing this occasion with her presence. We are fortunate to find the presence of extremely eminent personalities this morning. We are happy with the august presence of Professor M.A. Oommen's former student, Sri T.P. Senkumar, IPS, DGP and State Police Chief. We are equally privileged to have the esteemed presence of Dr. A.M. Mathai, Professor Maman Vakki, Dr. John Samuel and Sri C. Gaudidasan Nair for their words of felicitations. I take this opportunity to reiterate my sincere thanks to Dr. Amit Chauvan Ray, Director, Center for Development Studies, for being very supportive and receptive to Kerala Economic Association. We are extremely grateful to Dr. Ash Naren Roy for his keen interest and initiative in launching the book in honor of Professor M.A. Oommen. We acknowledge your effort and presence in this elite gathering. Thank you, sir. We thank also the distinguished authors from Nobel Laureate, Professor Amartya Sen to Madam J. Devika. I thank all esteemed guests, distinguished speakers, special invitees who have accepted our invitation and given generously of their time. An event of this magnitude requires meticulous planning and execution. I take this opportunity to thank my colleagues who have demonstrated initiative and involvement at every step and made the task easier and fruitful. I would like to thank Dr. G.M. Prasad and Srimati Shanta Karthikeyan, who masterminded the whole tribute, collapsing Professor M.A. Oommen's productive life in a succinct fashion. We are also grateful to all the sponsors and the media for their continued support. From my heart of heart, with immense pleasure, let me avail this opportunity to express vote of thanks to Professor M.A. Oommen, our beloved mentor. Thank you all.
National Anthem.
Jana Gana Mana Adhinayaka Jaya Hind Bharata Bhagya Vidhata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravida Utkala Vanga Vindhya Himachala Yamuna Ganga Uchchala Jaladhi Taranga Tava Shubha Name Jage शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल गाए
Thank you all.
Thank you very much.